three items I took note of. First, Chairman Gaston was talking about the context within which all of these Lumad issues are happening, and this is the conflict, the armed struggle being waged by the CPP, NPA, and the other. And also mentioned were recommendations both by Chito and from the UN also on things that we can do or that we need to do. And there are also some recommendations on current and future activities that we need to do. But first, let me say that there are many talks going around, there are many information being peddled around, but we need to distinguish between propaganda and truth. As this is happening in the context of a conflict, a lot of propaganda are going around. Let me just give you an idea on what this conflict is all about, what this armed struggle is all about, and what the CPP-NPA is trying to do to give the bigger context, the bigger picture. Note that I've dissected this into three levels: strategic, the operational, and the tactical level. As I mentioned earlier, there's an armed struggle being waged, and I would like to say that all of this happening, all of this human rights violation happening, the root cause is this armed conflict. And therefore, the solution is also to end this armed conflict. At the strategic level, you will notice that the armed struggle continues to be waged. And what they're doing is still pursuing this armed struggle. Their primary means of effecting political change remains to be armed struggle. And as the UN resident coordinator has said, has mentioned also, the peace talks. Yes, government is for the peace talks. In fact, what they're doing is trying to pressure us to go back to the negotiating table. It is not government that withdrew from the negotiating table. It is the CPP, NPA, and the F. Government remains seated on the table, waiting for the CPP, NPA, and the F to return without any preconditions. And that has been the difficulty of the resumption of talks. The preconditions are being set by the CPP, NPA before they return to the negotiating table. Well, the purpose really, from the CNN point of view, I am referring to the CPP, NPA, NDF, is not really for a negotiated political solution. Government's intention is serious negotiated political solution to end this conflict peacefully through the negotiating table rather than through arms. Unfortunately, the CPP, NPA has a different perspective. As I said, their primary means of achieving political change remains to be armed struggle, that, and everything they do, including the peace negotiations, is in support of that armed struggle. One of the preconditions I was mentioning is the release of the top leadership of the CPP, NPA, and the NPA, Changson et al., who are now facing court cases, and they would like to get away from this and also allow the release of all the other NPA leadership in jail. Government of the Republic of the Philippines, like any UN member, adheres to the rule of law. And in this case, that is also the truth. We are adhering to the rule of law, let the court resolve these issues on whether to release or retain in jail the CPP and PA leadership. And that is what we have been doing these past few years. But also, election is fast approaching. Again, the CPP and PA is using this opportunity to advance the competitiveness of their candidates, supported candidates. At the operational level, they would want to discredit government and stop the implementation of IPSB Bayanihan. Internal Peace and Security Plan Bayanihan, which they equate to Lumad killings. Those of you who have read IPSB Bayanihan knows better. In fact, this government campaign, this military campaign, is the only military campaign which is open to the public, which is very transparent, that everybody can read, you and I can read, downloadable from the internet. And I'd like to suggest for those of you who have not read this document yet, please read this document and find out for yourself whether Bayanihan is equal to Lumad killing, or Bayanihan is rather to win the peace. You have noticed that the CPP-NPA tried to gain propaganda mileage during the last week, bringing some of the Lumads from Mindanao, even bringing them from Mindanao to Manila. Imagine all the hardships they went through just to show them off during APEC. And that is very unfortunate. That is very unfortunate. As mentioned by the UN coordinator, using, that is one of the instances where you use the Lumads for political ends. That's very unfortunate. Also, we have been conducting servicio caravans, bringing government services specifically to the Lumad areas. And it is gaining traction, winning the Lumads towards the government. And that does not sit well. And so they have to negate the effects of these servicio caravans. And lastly, at the operational level, government of the Republic of the Philippines is winning the peace in many areas of our country through our campaign plan Bayanihan. The last bastion that the NPAs are strong is Eastern Mindanao, specifically the Lumad areas. And they would like to defend this last bastion. What they have been doing is really in defense of this last bastion, their last stronghold. Militarily, they could not win over government, and therefore they had to use massive propaganda. Earlier, I mentioned we have to distinguish between propaganda and truth. Many of the information going around are propaganda. Some of them are truth, and so we have to distinguish between the two. At the tactical level, they're trying to frustrate the deployment of the Bayanihan teams, the peace and development teams that go into the communities for the purpose of identifying the core issues that needs to be resolved. And so, there is a deliberate effort to frustrate these Bayanihan teams, the peace and development teams, going into the communities, identifying the core issues that are being used to agitate our people to take up arms against government, and so that government can address these core issues. So just to give you the bigger context, this is what the CPP-NPA is trying to do, and all that is happening, all the propaganda that you hear are in the context of this bigger picture. Now mentioned also our recommendations on what the government should do. Chito mentioned about the Whole of Nation initiative. But let me tell you what government is doing to address this Lumad issue. This issue surfaced September 1 during the death of Samarca et al. Et al. And the three. Yes. September 1. But even before that, government was focused on addressing the Lumad issues. Last year, a task force was created, Task Force on Whole of Nation Initiative, purposely to address these issues. Let me talk about that Whole of Nation Initiative. This did not come out last September, 3 months ago. This was initiated last year when the Task Force on the Whole of Nation Initiative was activated. The Whole of Nation Initiative is a government program to address the Lumad issues. Given the situation in Eastern Mindanao, their last bastion, as I mentioned, where 74% of the NPAs are Lumads, where admittedly there is inaccessibility of government services. Note also that 90% of the guerrilla bases are located in this ancestral domain where the IPs live. And half, almost half of the population in Eastern Mindanao are IPs. Now, what are the issues that are being used by the NPAs to radicalize the IPs? To turn them into rebels, to agitate them to take up arms against government. And these are the issues, whether real or perceived. First is the respect over ancestral domain. Second, the availability of basic services. Third, exclusion from economic development planning and security and customary defense. These are the issues we have identified that are being used by the NPA to radicalize our IPs. And we have outlined government interventions to squarely address those issues on the right. And these are empowering the IPs through facilitating rightful ownership of ancestral domains, prioritizing IP needs and development plan of key response agencies, and assisting the NCIP in advancing IP concerns, the National Commission on Indigenous Peoples. We're trying to empower and support the NCIP to play a more prominent role. Note that government's effort is IP-centric, precisely because of the conditions that prevail in Eastern Mindanao. Recognizing that fact, even before all of these issues surfaced, a focused, deliberate government campaign intervention to address the IP issues.
Can you go to the next?
Breaking down that intervention into several government aspects, not just security. But just to mention, security includes running after the perpetrators, not just in the Lianga killing, but also for those who killed Mayor Otasa. And the rest of the IPs, hundreds of them killed in the past several years. Most of them by the CPP, NPA, NDF. The security aspect includes running after all armed groups. And there is a very firm directive from the president to do that, to run after all these armed groups, including the New People's Army, which is the biggest armed group in this part of Mindanao. On the legal aspect, aside from the delivery of basic services, the prosecution of the perpetrators, not just Ilianga but also Mayor Otasa and the other killings, are being pursued. The chairman of CHR just mentioned that their efforts. That there is an ongoing DOJ investigation. But more importantly, government has focused on social protection, setting up schools, recognizing the fact, as highlighted, that there needs to be more schools set up in that part of the country. The situation there is far more different from the rest of the Philippines, where communities are separated by mountains, and therefore there needs to be more schools built. And that is not a very easy task. Although DepEd has really set its mind on fulfilling that commitment to set up schools in all those communities for the next 6 months. Health issues being addressed by DOH, including PhilHealth. Social welfare issues, where DSWD is taking the lead. The biggest component in terms of funding is the development issues. Roads, bridges, water system, electrification, and DPWH is taking the lead in this respect. There is also a governance aspect in this, addressing the issues of governance. Can you go to the next? This is again, it's an elaboration of the needs identified in the WNI areas. I'm referring to the Eastern Mindanao area, with the different aspects of governance. As you will see, there is a comprehensive focused government effort to address the IP issues. 16 billion is being programmed to address all of these issues. There is immediate funding release for 2015 to pursue the more immediate needs. In the 2016 budget, through the PAMANA and other programs, the government has allocated about 7 billion to address these issues, and the rest will be programmed from other sources. Many have shown interest on the Lumads and their plight, and we invite our people to join government, as this is a whole of nation initiative. This is not just government that needs to act. All of us, as a people, this is supposed to be a people's initiative. Simply expressing our support, expressing our inclusiveness, is a big help to the government effort. And it is fortunate that the United Nations and members of the International Committee are here as well to recognize what we're doing and find ways on how we can help in the prosecution of these activities. As I mentioned earlier, many propaganda are going around. Many of our embassies or ambassadors, even the United Nations, has been approached to advance the Lumad issues, but from a different perspective. And we hope you realize also that there is a government narrative to this, that the government narrative is the truth, government does not engage in propaganda. And we are bearing to you all of these facts. And for the two major incidents I mentioned earlier, the Lianga killing and the killing of Mayor Otasa, there is a vigorous effort by government, not just to address them legally through the rule of law, but also to physically run after the perpetrators of these criminal acts. Again, I would like to thank all of you. Should there be any questions, I'd be most willing to clarify any of those points. Thank you very much.